and welcome to Everything Edinburgh here at EUTV. You are here with Ben.
And Gazelle. Now, Gazelle, I'm not sure about you, but I feel like I'm something straight out of the university prospectus here at Old College, home to the Edinburgh University Law School.
It is really pretty, isn't it? But it is quite cold. So let's have a look at the brief news this week. Now, Donald Trump has been elected as the new US president, which has drastically changed the political landscape in the US.
And from one salty cheese to another, the halloumi burger is back in business at TV at Row House.
Which is particularly good for vegetarians like me.
Now, I'm sure you guys know the drill by now. We've got four sections to cover here on EUTV today. We have politics, sport, events, but first, lifestyle.
Now, I know that we've all been trying to avoid it, and I get completely why, but it's exam time now, and we need to retreat into the library like bears into hibernation.
Now, our lifestyle team have been looking at the top five places to study as an alternative to the library.
Cafes are a great place to study if you need a bit of a caffeine kick and feel like getting off campus. Black Medicine Coffee Company has a cosy wooden decor and lots of space for your books and laptops downstairs. With a great range of food, hot drinks and smoothies, you can find it on the corner of Nicholson Street and Drummond Street.
An underused facility is the ability to book rooms here at David Hume Tower and other facilities around all campuses of the uni. We tried it out to see how the system works. They're perfect for group work or if you want to study on campus but can't quite find it in you to get up early enough to be able to secure a library seat come exam time.
The Balcony Cafe, which is on level 3 of the National Museum of Scotland, is a great place to study. There's plugs for your laptops and free Wi-Fi, and then you can grab a coffee or a snack while you're there as well. And if you want to take a break from learning, why not go and look at the exhibits?
As the only free public study space in Edinburgh, the Central Library is the perfect place to get away from the distractions of campus. It's got all the stuff you need for a good revision session, including free Wi-Fi, big tables, and all the resources you could possibly need.
Here's three ways to actually turn your desk into a productive study space. The laptop extension self-control allows you to blacklist unproductive websites for up to 24 hours at a time. A second way to maximise productivity is to use the Pomodoro technique. Work for 25 minutes and take a 5-minute break. The short bursts of activity ensure that you stick to the task at hand. And we're sure you've heard it all before, but make sure you stay hydrated, even if that does mean 10 mugs of tea a day.
Thank you, Lifestyle. Now over to our sports team, who have been covering the This Edinburgh Girl Can campaign. Now this is part of a national effort by Sports England to celebrate the achievement of active women all over the UK.
Our sports union have been putting on taster sessions and our coverage joined them down at Pepper Mill for the women's football.
This week in the Edinburgh Girl Can campaign, we've been focusing on trying to get more women involved in sport.
It's all about getting rid of those like stigmas and barriers to participation in sport, and it's just making sure that girls or women feel comfortable taking part in sport.
In second year, I bumped into this girl at a party and we started talking about our mutual love for dogs. Ended up talking about cheerleading, and she was like, oh yes, my cheer squad, blah blah blah, and I was like, there's a cheer squad at Edinburgh University. I must go, and that's how I got into it.
There's still a massive disparity between sports that are seen as traditionally male. Therefore, we need to break these stereotypes and continue to foster success and show girls that gender shouldn't be a barrier to participating in sport.
We've just got involved in setting up this intramural league so that we can have like some competitive football like at a lower level, but a really, really fun level for other players.
Everyone, especially at university, this university more than any other, everyone's so welcoming. Like, as soon as you're in the door, that's it, you're there and you'll enjoy it and you'll come back.
Listen to what people say. If people are saying it's not a sport for girls, don't do that. It's not girly, whatever. Just go along, give it a try, you never know unless you're going to love it. We're going to have you saying it.
After the landmark decision to leave the EU back in June, Scotland now faces the imminent prospect of another independence referendum.
Our politics team took to the streets to gauge popular student opinion, as well as interviewing members of the Scottish Parliament at a recent debate held by our very own debate union.
I think we're verging on the terms of inevitability now. I think in due course, potentially before the next Scottish election, I think a second independence referendum might be the best way, or the only way, to secure Scotland's place in the European Union.
I've met a lot of people who will say that the last thing they want is another independence referendum, so I think the uncertainty around that is something we shouldn't move forward with.
The reality is that Brexit's going to have negative consequences of Scotland, but independence is Brexit times four. Four times the size of a trading bloc that we have with the rest of the EU, we have with the rest of the United Kingdom. The NHS, which I care so passionately about, yes, will be impacted by not having access to EU staff, which is about 3%. In actual fact, 12% come from other parts of the United Kingdom. So I don't want uncertainty. I want us to have open borders and to be a welcoming, open nation. And I don't think we should close in on ourselves.
I regret the fact that people who either voted for both unions or against both unions might be forced to choose which one matters most to them, or indeed which one they're willing to put up with. But it seems that we can't have both UK membership and EU membership unless the UK government is willing to change track and allow a bespoke solution for Scotland. At the moment, they're ruling that out.
And if you could think of one word to sum up the political landscape of 2016 for me, what one would you like to use?
Well, I think probably just a big sigh.
Dumpster fire.
Eventful.
Shameful.
And inspiring.
Chaos.
I think that's the tone of most of our students on campus.
Recently, our events team made their way to the TEDx Salon here in Edinburgh.
Let's have a chat with Zoe to find out more.
I'm here at TEDx University of Edinburgh's Salon event, What's Next? Tonight we're going to be hearing from a range of speakers, including university staff, entrepreneurs from around Edinburgh, and the audience here are also going to have the chance to have an open mic session.
At the moment, we're running a program where we are training up these student speakers to have confidence to give a TED-style talk. And they're going to be talking for 5 minutes on stage at one of our events at the end of November called the Student Speaker Choice Awards.
So that's your lot from Everything Edinburgh here on EUTV.
We hope you enjoyed yourselves, we certainly did, and until next time, goodbye.
Goodbye.